So for this tutorial, we're going to take what we've learned with the type tool and combine it with what we've learned about the pen tool and the direct selection tool to completely create customized text. Now this opens up a whole world of possibilities in communicating with text. Especially as we start to embark on our own logo designs, this type of technique is going to become absolutely critical in creating some really cool stuff. So let's get in here. I'm starting off with a regular web large artboard. Let's go ahead and get our type tool selected. And for this, I'm going to be using Franklin Gothic Demi Regular. If you guys are on a Mac, you guys can use something like Arial Bold or Helvetica Bold. I'm going to click in the middle of my artboard, and I'm just going to choose a letter. In this case, I'm going to use the uppercase M. I'm going to double click my T icon, and I'm going to increase the size of my text in my option bar to fill my artboard. Now let's say that a company's hired me to make a logo with the letter M. Let's say they're a pizza restaurant and they want one of these triangles here to look like a pizza slice. Well, we would need now to be able to edit this text as if it were a shape, because we could get out then our direct selection tool and our pen tool and begin to work with it just like we did in our previous examples with the pen tool. Now, this is not a hard thing to do, meaning all we have to do is go over to our layer panel, right-click the layer, and select Convert to Shape. Now, before you hit this, I want you guys to realize that this is a destructive change, meaning once we convert this to a shape, it is no longer a text file. So the things like leading and kerning and changing the font, that's gone. But it does open up a world of shape properties. So if you like the way your text looks in your artboard, go ahead and hit Convert to Shape. If not, pause this now, work with your text, and then meet me here. I'm going to go ahead and hit Convert to Shape. Now, visually speaking, nothing has changed in my artboard itself. The M still looks just as it did. But notice how the layer thumbnail has changed from the type T to the shape thumbnail with the little square. So now our type tool doesn't do anything with the text anymore. Rather, if we get out our direct selection tool, our white arrow right underneath the type tool, I can now come to any of these vertices, select them, and begin to move them. I am now editing the actual shape data of the text itself. But we still need to make this triangle look like a pizza slice. To do this, I'm going to use my pen tool. Because now, since it's a shape, I can come and hover over any of these. Let me zoom in here. Hover over any of these lines, and you see how the plus appears. I can now add vertices. I'm going to add a few here. And now with my direct selection tool, I can come back and begin to completely kind of mold this as if it were clay. I'm not sure that really looks a whole lot like pizza, but you guys are getting the gist. We can now kind of see a shape inside of our fonts and bring it out using our direct selection tool and our pen tool. Now I want to make note, we still only have one layer in our layer panel, the M. We don't have any other shapes existing with our M. If you get out the pen tool and you begin to draw something else, look, we've made a new shape. We haven't changed the data of the M itself. Now, adding shapes is fine. Sometimes it can really go a long way in communicating what you're wanting. But for this exercise, I'm wanting you guys to focus on changing the actual shape data of the text itself. And this takes us to our text manipulation PSD. You'll find this on Canvas. I give you guys three words here, snake, balloon, and sharp, as three separate text layers. Now, I chose these three words because each one of them has a letter in it that could exemplify the essence of that word. The S in snake, the O's in balloon, and sharp is just kind of a free-for-all. So take a look at these words. Envision in your mind's eye the snake for the S. Envision balloons for the O's. Convert them to shapes, and then begin to pull out and form those shapes into what you're envisioning. Now, if you have a hard time envisioning things, this could be difficult. Just as if you had a block of clay, if you can't envision the pot, you're going to have a really hard time making it. Use a picture reference. Sketch something out if you need to. But I want you guys to take some time and manipulate those letters into something new. Now, I'm going to go ahead and time-lapse me doing this so you guys can kind of get a gist of what I'm going for. But if you don't want to watch that and you just want to play with it by yourself, you totally can. Come back and watch that later. We're going to move on after this into logo design. And logo design really is the combination of the pen tool and the type tool. So check it out as I work through these. Otherwise, head toward the next tutorial.